It is my great pleasure to welcome Joe Alessi here today. I can't believe, but Joe and I have known each other for 24 years. And first met him as a fledgling Curtis student, taking the train up to New York to take lessons with him on the side. And then as my career progressed, I would always go and play for him. And he would always provide such incredible insight. And you know, he's just been such an incredible beacon of our artistry and what we do. Now I'm in this phase of my career where I can actually bring him in to be a guest faculty here at Duquesne, and it's a real pleasure. So please welcome, man who really needs no introduction, Joseph Close.
Thank you. loud in this room. I love it.
No, it's just Pittsburgh.
All right, so so it's a little treacherous, that piece, but it's beautiful tonight. It's not available for trombone, but it's available out there. It says on the card just it says instrument. So any instrument could play it. All right, now the next tune is something I did. I love this piece of my good friend Håkan Björkman. Who knows Håkan Björkman? This great Swedish soloist. Look him up on YouTube. And anyway, he's a wonderful guy and wonderful musician. And I saw him play this piece on YouTube, and I fell in love with it by Philip Spark. It's from his trombone concerto. And the last one is called Sam Betsy. It's a little samba. And it's a lot of fun. Recently, I played Music of the Spheres. Does anybody know that piece? It's a brass band piece, and I played the brass band of Battle Creek. And Philip Spark came to the concert, and I had the courage enough to ask him if he would write a new piece, and I've suggested a tango, because we don't have anything like that for trombone and piano, a tango. So I said you could call it Tangetsi, you know. Anyway, so I think he's considering doing that. And all right, here we go. Thank you. regimented warm-up and routine, maintenance routine. If you go to the Philharmonic and, you know, you happen to be playing with us, you'll hear all the brass players warming up and doing, you know, fundamental things. Nothing too difficult. You don't hear people showing off with solos. You just hear them doing scales and slurs. And if you go to if you went to the Pittsburgh Symphony and hung around the brass players, that's what you hear before the concert. So it's funny how the people who respect fundamentals, they do very well. So I think that's something that everybody just has to, there's no shortcut, okay? Even our teacher, Glenn Dotson, said, you know, he always said, "Oh, I don't warm up." He said, warming up is just warming, letting the metal warm up. But sure enough, backstage at the Philadelphia Orchestra, you would do this little routine. And maybe you wouldn't admit it to too many people, but I heard it. So, all right, so anyway, what I want to get to is the other side of this is being a musician, okay? And that's I think, what we're not concentrating on enough. So, I've given this little lecture all around the world. So if you've heard it before, I'm sorry, but it's words that end in C-I-A-N. So please help me, audience. What do you like, musician? So.
Statistician,
thank you. Another one?
Physician.
What's that?
Physician.
Physician, thank you.
Technician.
How about, okay, let's say you put certified in front of them. Certified technician, they've gone through a test, and they've been approved by the state board. You can do that with, if you do that with a politician, that means something different. but technician, how about electrician? Let's look at that word. Now, what does the electrician have to know besides electricity?
Electrical code,
thank you. And how about positive and negative? That's a very simple thing. Even we know that. So you can't connect the red wire with the green wire, right? And when you put the battery in, whatever, you know what I'm talking about. So, but you hire an electrician, he's a certified electrician, he comes over and he connects the red wire with the green wire and connects positive to negative and charges you $1,000 and then he leaves and you've been hacked. You know, he's a fake. This guy just doesn't know what he's doing. So anyway, let's go over to the musician. What is the musician, if you think of it in basic terms, what does the musician have to know? Yeah, he needs to know nothing, I guess. Okay. He needs to know rhythm and pitch, right? This is the things that come up more often than not, and you know, 90% of people who go to the symphony auditions or whatever, you know, don't know rhythm and pitch. And it's only the 10% that do that seem to go on and do well in the other rounds. So rhythm and pitch is really what you have to have. Now, and to expose yourself as a real musician, you have to practice that in the practice room. And you have to put the instrument down and then realize that the real instrument is here. Okay, and you have to expose it and prove to yourself that you're a musician. And then, you know, because we've studied all this technique and we've studied legato and we've studied all this stuff, but we're leaving out the most important thing. So we need to sing with our voice, and conduct. Sing and conduct everything you play. Okay, when you do that, you will know exactly how to play something. Okay, so give me anything that I'll sing and conduct.
Palmera.
Okay. You're gonna sing and conduct the arrow. Ready? One and two and three and four and seven. Hold on. One, two, three and four and five and six and one, two and three, four, five and six and one, two, three and four and five, six, one, two. Four, five, six, one, two, three, four, five, six, one, and three, four, and five, six, and one, and two, and three, and four, five, six, one, two, three. Okay, there we go. So. Yeah, all right. But let's say, you know, it could be anything, laundry. That's the beginning. That's another thing, is that if you do practice an excerpt, you know the whole piece, or you just know the excerpt. Okay, right? So what I'm doing, I'm singing, I'm conducting with an ictus. So you don't, many times I'll ask students to do this, and they'll this is just a nebulous kind of thing, and the pitches are not right, and there's no expression, and they don't practice with the breaths, how to breathe. You can practice your breathing, you can practice your phrasing. But if you're really comfortable with showing your musicianship and without the instrument, I'm telling you, it pays off big time. So are you a musician? We're not trombone players, we're musicians that happen to play trombone. And I think you have to remember that, and in the practice room, you have to, you know, show you're a certified musician. So here's my wish. Thank you.
big round of applause.
You know, one of my students at Juilliard, we had a little class like this, and I said, you know, who wants to play? Well, she didn't raise her hand, and I said, why, come on, you have to raise your hand. If you have a chance to play in a master class, you should be the first person to raise your hand. It's a big experience, you know, to learn how to deal with all kinds of things. And so anyway, and I also tell people, calm down. You're not here to prove anything necessarily. We're just here to talk about concepts, and that's all we're really doing. All right, nice job. Now, I think the first comment I would say is we got to make things more compact. Okay, I think you're thinking too wide with everything, and with the size of the notes and your sound. I think you need to get everything. Rein everything in here. Okay? So that's the first thing I would say. The second thing is, yeah, there's some technique we have to work on. Okay, so, but mainly, let's get the notes a little bit shorter. Okay? And let's work on, keep the slide, keep everything coordinated. I think if we're breaking apart the timing of our tongue, our air, and our slide. This is, you know, this is the hardest thing about playing trombone, classical trombone, or any jazz, any kind of trombone. It's just, you know, keeping everything coordinated so we can do what we want to do up here. And that brings me to my next thing is, I think we have to, have you ever just had a session where you sing and conduct this?
No.
I think you need to do that because sometimes you got a little bit of, pretty far away from what rhythmically should happen, okay? Now, it's a big epic beginning, okay, so it's one of the biggest introductions for trombone, actually, any trombone concerto, so it's when you do come in, it's, you know, building up, I call it a Hollywood, you know, once kind of a Hollywood beginning, so it's pretty epic, and so I'd like, let's just start right at 8, okay? Oh, before you go on, hardest thing about this piece is getting this rhythm correct. Okay, we can't cheat and fudge this rhythm. I think it's, people want to cheat it and fudge it because it's hard to go dee ba da ba ba ba. It's very hard to do that and it's very awkward on our instrument. But you have to practice that. You have to practice that and you can't turn it into a triplet. Okay, so the way you would do that is you would play just beep, ba. That's pretty easy, actually. Just do that by yourself. Just play it and stop on the G. Sing it and put up.
Ba, ba.
That time you wait. So that's the other thing. Is this 16th note, if you think of it really carefully, it's almost on the fourth beat. But we always think of it as something that has to happen as part of the third beat. I would say it needs to be part of the fourth beat. Okay, so try that. If you have trouble with that, then just simply place the 16th on the fourth beat. Good. Now add the triplet. Slows down automatically. So you have to think of the triplet once you get to the triplet. Drive it forward. Okay? But really, it's a package deal. Bum, ba da ba ba ba. Singing conductor.
Bum, ba da ba ba ba.
Do you wait? Close. Bum, ba da ba ba ba. More to be had here with this E flat than you think. then play it and see if it matches what you're hearing in your brain, okay? But we get anxious. Everybody gets anxious because we want to have to do this awkward thing. Beep, ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Right?
Yeah.
All right. Good. Well, let's start again with the piano. But the last note, also the B flat, really is the same. Okay. And make it epic again. Here we go. One, two, three, four. Basic thing, and this piece is all over the place. It's a note above or below that's like a suspension or a dissonant note sometimes, but it's what it means is it means to lean on the note. You have to lean on the note, right? And de-lean. All right, so here we go. One more time. Let's just start, pick up right here. Begin now is excellent. Which note? Which note? Yeah, you did. You did. Sometimes the highest note is not the most important note. Yes. has a very acute affliction of this. Slide hyperactivity disorder.
Okay. One, two, three.
Okay, so I've talked to some of the students already about this. You need to, for legato playing, I think we all know that you have to move your slide as late as possible. Right? Does everybody agree on that? But for me, the detached playing, it's different for me. And I know people have talked about this, but I like to move the slide right away, right after the note is completed. So what we're going to do is we're going to do a little exercise. Okay, and we play E flat major and just do this. Have you ever done that exercise?
Yeah.
You have?
Yeah.
Where?
Ian Boosfield, that's on YouTube.
Oh, okay. No, what did you learn from?
What we're doing
when we do this, we increase the zone where we can move the slide. Okay, now it's wide open. Okay, so what we're going to do, it's called the hot note exercise. So if you touch this stand red hot, you go like that. So if you touch the note, right?
Yeah.
Let's do that.
Thank you.
for a high note, okay? Usually, high notes are kind of the focus of phrase or come to the big spot. You usually don't breathe before the high note. Okay, so in this case, your low notes are the high notes. So you can't, every low note, you can't go, blah, right? You have to lead to it, right? So you should always, bass trombone players should always think about that. When they're going to a big fat note, we want to hear you come from something, not put a big wall between. Then it's impressive, right? You can play these notes, but you got to lead to them. So I would adjust some of these breaths. That's kind of what we did last week. We did a lot of picking and choosing where to breathe. So anyway, let's think about that. See if you can do that on the fly. It'll make quick adjustments. When you also the other thing about pieces with no accompaniment. Okay, you shouldn't with the accompaniment. We can always kind of use the piano to hide breath. Okay, and so you have to make that can't happen here. So you have to kind of move through things a little bit more. I think that's important. That piece just by its trombone by itself, we shouldn't have big giant pauses. Let's keep the music moving and going. Okay, so let's try this again. I'm here just before the opening. Just ba 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 ba. Well, it's not that. Ba 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 ba. It's a trip. Ba 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 ba. Coming up dynamically, and then you come down. And Now, the This is a position of non-confidence. Okay, this is a position of Try this again.
Thank you.
anything. So I think you're thinking you're a little square on all this. Let me just show you what I mean. But you just, you'd have to, so just pick up the A.
Thank you.
Natural place to breathe is here, and then this is a technique, but with your with the music make. Okay, so let's do this again. just directly when the breeze starts. Right? So that's a way to connect phrases. do here, this is your mask. My mother was a singer, and she talked about the mask. And it's the same thing for a brass player. The mask has to be correct. Okay, so if you start messing around with this mask, things are going to get, you know, out of control. So, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Letter E.
Thank you.
play over all the eight notes. So half of them. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Breathe. Don't breathe on eighth note. Breathe after the eighth. Okay, can we do the same place?
Two, three, four. little directly into the air.
Bobby, Bob. Important, they write fortissimo at that moment.